Hey guys, another edition of some skincare reviews. Actually gonna throw in a few body care items. We got a couple hair items in here that I used over the winter time. Definitely want to share with you what I think is good to repurchase or not repurchase. So if you're interested in what we got into this past winter and you love skincare reviews as much as I do, then keep on watching. Can you spot the dots? So what's been trending these last, I think probably a couple of years, are these little patches or dots that you can put on maybe a pimple or a zit that is really bothering you and you want to treat it throughout the day. This is from Artistry Studio. They have 0.5% salicylic acid in them, so it'll help treat that inflammation, and they're clear patches so that you don't see them at all, which is really nice. And I found these to work very, very well. I highly recommend these. Body Patch is another brand. These are specific for dark spots. They have tiny little micro points, so they really grip the skin well. And this particular type of dot is full of hyaluronic acid. It has tranexamic acid, which really helps to brighten the area that might be scarred over time. It has a small amount of ascorbic acid. Also has hyaluronic acid to keep the area dry. And squalane and niacinamide, those all help with brightening. I don't know how much ascorbic acid you're really getting in there, because ascorbic acids need to work at a certain pH level, and you can't really measure that in these little patches, but because it has a tranexamic acid in there, and also the niacinamide and squalane, I'd still recommend using these for dark spots. Another favorite I was using this winter came in my test tube beauty subscription box is the Stress Rescue Super Serum by Dr. Dennis Gross. So this serum is chock full of great antioxidants. I don't necessarily have stressed skin, but I did like that I was putting all these great nutrients and antioxidants into my skin and superfoods, because that really helps with youthful glow and cell turnover. However, if you were someone that had sensitive skin or sensitized skin, this would be a really good serum for you. I can see this being very beneficial. Highly recommend. So by Dennis Gross, I got a sample of the Hyaluronic Marine Melt Away Cleanser. Absolutely love this cleanser. It's a nice cream-based cleanser. I don't necessarily use it to rely on getting makeup off though, in addition to whatever dirt and oil. I'm a huge double cleanse person, so I can't speak that it would get off all your makeup, because my makeup was usually removed first and then I would use it. But let's say my cleansing balm didn't get all my makeup, then this would be another way to ensure I'm getting all that off my skin. But my skin always felt really hydrated and clean without feeling stressed as far as too stripped with this cleanser, so highly recommend. Another serum I really liked, again from my test tube subscription, was by Dr. Zenobia. It's a hyaluronic acid peptide serum. We should all know by now how beneficial hyaluronic acid is to our skin. It's in everything. It helps with hydration. It holds 1,000 times its weight in water to help keep your skin looking plump. And then you add peptides into this, and I thought, oh, that's a game changer, because peptides are amino acid chains and they're part of what's needed for collagen and elastin. So if you want to strengthen and build more collagen and elastin, having peptides in your skincare really help create that momentum. I don't know if I repurchased it, not because I didn't like it, but I feel like there are less expensive options on the market now that have both of these ingredients in them. But I did like the product, and I would recommend it if you do want to get into some Dr. Zenobia. Another skincare item are the Eye Look Rested Deep Puffer Brightener Eye Gel Pads, again by Artistry Studio. I just love that they were a really pretty teal color. Don't we buy stuff by the way it looks sometimes? It's like a pearlescent turquoise. I love it. But they work really well. They hydrate and depuff under my eyes. I mean, it has a little bit of caffeine in it. It has allotonin, which helps with soothing the eye area if you're, if you have stressed under eye skin. So I do like them. I put them in my fridge to keep them cold, and then I use them in the morning for like 10, 15 minutes. They stay in place, which is a big bugaboo of mine. I don't like eye gel pads that move around. Another new product by Dermalogica released late last year was their Neck Fit Contour Serum. Really like this product. The reasons why I like it are, yes, the ingredients are great and they will help with the skin in this area. This area of our neck and our décolleté, when we get sun damage here, it's really hard to reverse. So the best way to do that is with sunscreen. But here we are, if we're already in our middle age or mid 30s and up, we may have already caused some damage. So we should definitely treat this area. Always want to hydrate this area. But sometimes the skin here is very sensitive. This doesn't bother the skin in this area, I found, at all. I love it because of this roller. So you have control as to how much you're going to put on. And that particular applicator helps ensure even distribution onto the skin. So we're not touching it. I'm really a big fan of not having to touch any active ingredients in our skincare, because this has a lot of active antioxidants. We don't want to compromise it with our fingers. You know, not that say we're not clean, but if we don't have to touch the product, then why should we? So I do like it for that reason, and I definitely will be repurchasing. This product surprised me. This is a retinol clearing oil by Dermalogica that came out, I think, last year as well. And I wasn't sure if I would like it because it's an oil, not because I don't like oil on my skin. I do like some oils on my skin. These are oils that are not going to be clogging at all. But I'm like, is retinol really going to work in an oil? But I will say I was very impressed with this. Right after the first use of using this retinol clearing oil, my skin felt like I had used some type of chemical exfoliant when I hadn't. And it's meant to help with adult acne, and I like that about this product a lot. And you don't need a lot of it. You can use it pretty frequently. It doesn't dry out the skin because it's full of all these great phytonutrient oils, so you won't compromise your skin. This is a great beginning retinol routine for someone that's kind of wants to dip their toe in retinol and they're a little nervous about it. It's a good starting retinol routine. This isn't skincare, but it's hair care, and it falls under the category of body care, right? Redken launched this great line called Acidic Bonding Concentrate. They have a shampoo, they have a conditioner, and they also have a acidic perfecting concentrate. This is a leave-in treatment. And I'm blown away by this line. I can't even believe how hydrated my hair feels. And I started by just using this because I love to stick with a purple shampoo and conditioner for the blonde. And this is color safe, though. You can use this on color treated hair. When I started, I just used the leave-in treatment after I come out of the shower, and my hair brushes so easily, and it actually looks shiny. I've never really felt like I had shiny hair. I will say that this really helps my shine factor a lot, and then it's even better when I do use the shampoo and conditioner, so I highly recommend that too. Okay, so we do have some things that didn't work out, and I won't repurchase, and I wouldn't necessarily recommend buying. I mean, you can, but it's okay. I love Elemis. Elemis is one of my favorite skincare brands, but this Elemis Superfood Cleansing Butter, it's okay. I felt like it was a good, rich cleanser on the skin, but I didn't really notice anything totally different with my skin. I bought it because I liked that it had the pumpkin enzyme, which is a great antioxidant. Nothing wrong with it. I just didn't wow me enough, and I do like a lot of Elemis's cleansing balms, and I thought I would like this, but not so much. This is a recent purchase. It came in my Test Tube Beauty subscription box. It's the Wake Up and Glow Revitalizing Face Mist by Manakadar. Well, one thing I like about all these Test Tube subscriptions that I'm getting is that I'm really tapping into skincare I normally would never buy myself, and I love that about this subscription service. However, this was not the best choice. I can't even use this on my face. It smells like straight up perfume. There's so much fragrance in this, I can't even get past it. Like, maybe you spray it on your body if you want to hydrate your body. You don't really care if it smells this perfume. This has this much perfume, but I would not recommend that. Another item that didn't quite make the cut was this cleansing mask with lemon by Christoph Robin. It was in my subscription service New Beauty, and I had high hopes with this because it's an ultra nourishing low shampoo product, and I'm like, ooh, this would be good. It says it's color safe, and you know, of course, if I don't need a lot of that extra stuff in my shampoo, then maybe, you know, I'll try it. I just didn't like it. I mean, the texture is really pretty. It's cool. Really doesn't have a lot of scent to it, but every time I used it, and I used it for a good solid week, I didn't feel like I was getting anything out of my hair. It was just, I guess I'm just used to having more things in my shampoo. So it didn't work out for me. Maybe you'd like to try it if you're into the low poo type of products, but kind of a not so much for me. Anyway, that does it for me. I hope you found this to be helpful. Maybe you're going to investigate some of these brands that I shared with you. And let me know your thoughts. If you have tried this, if you're using the Test Tube subscription service, I'd love to know what you think about it. Anyway, I thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.